All right, what up? It's Kelvin on the new Hits 97.3. We're here vibing out at the Clevelander Hits Hotel Miami Music Week. I'm here with the one, the only.
DJ Heat, baby, what up?
Yo, so I got to tell you, bro.
What's up?
It's a straight vibe here. You're playing tonight here at the Clevelander, right?
Yeah, I'm rocking at 4 o'clock, actually.
Nice. Is it your first time? No.
Not my first time here. First time playing here, though.
Nice.
Yeah,
very
so I'm excited.
Dope. So, did you end up going to Ultra last night? Are you going to Ultra this
weekend?
We did
not go there last night, but I saw that there was a fire amongst other things. So.
There was a fire, and there was, what else? A bunch of people couldn't make it over, apparently.
There's only one way in and one way out, though, right?
Right.
See, that's a disaster right there.
Is that the ultimate goal, though, for every DJ? I mean, correct me if I'm wrong. Is Ultra main headline one of the milestones of a career?
I feel like anybody that's into the scene, I mean, that's an accomplishment. You have to, have to need that. You know what I mean?
Right.
So it's cool.
What's been your favorite place that you've performed that you were like, yo, damn, I did it?
For me personally, it was Webster Hall in New York.
Nice.
I remember that night like it was yesterday. I walked in, I'm like, yo, we're actually doing this?
Yo,
like, this happened. You know?
That's so dope.
Very dope.
What advice do you have for someone that wants to get into DJing? You've been DJing for about 16 years. We're talking about that off mic.
Right, yeah, about 16 years. My biggest advice in 2019 is network. Meet people. Like, you can't just do this from your house. You have to go see people. You have to go shake hands.
That's right.
And do all that. Like, you have to be out here.
Mm. And I got to tell you, music has gone through a different phase, right? So I feel like pop music has gotten a little bit of hip hop. It's had its EDM phase. I feel like 2012, 2013, that was that era.
Absolutely.
Avicii kind of showed us that there was a vibe with folk and country EDM. What do you think for 2019 is popping right now?
I think we're going to see a lot more of like the Carnage thing happening, a lot more hip hop influenced things. Like, I wouldn't be surprised if we see like a Carnage and City Girls record happening, you know, stuff like that. Mm-hmm. I mean, everything like right now is all meshing together very well.
It is. And we were talking about this with a couple of DJs that were here before, and we were saying how US pop radio has kind of changed a little bit. Now we have Travis Scott on US pop radio.
Right.
Same thing with EDM. EDM is starting to make its way back, I feel, in that sense. How do you define your music? Where do you land on the scale? Is there a certain box or you don't like to define yourself?
I personally don't like boxes at all.
Okay.
I like to play everything. Like,
okay.
I started off as a hip hop guy. You know, I've done radio for 10 years. Like, we've literally touched every genre there is.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? And I think that's the best way to do it. You don't get bored that way.
Right. And where did, was this always the plan? Because some people go to college or whatever and they start studying something, but was this always a plan for you to be a DJ?
Absolutely.
Yeah?
I started doing clubs when I was like 16.
Damn.
So like, I dropped out of college first semester, and mm-hmm. like that's when like you know the bills were starting to get paid. I'm like, all right, you know, we're good.
Like, that's awesome.
So you know, and it's a blessing. It really is. Like, mm-hmm. I get to wake up every day and do what I do for you know as a dream.
Music.
Yeah.
Music
exactly.
is one of the best things in the world, and that's your job.
100%. And get paid to do it.
That's right.
It's amazing.
And let's be quite honest. It's very important to get paid.
Right.
Who has influenced your music? Do you have a certain person that you idolize in the EDM community? Even doesn't even have to be EDM.
All the way across the board, definitely my man Devolve. You know, DJ-wise, Camilo, I'm a big fan of him, especially, you know, just wide open palette. They play everything.
Right.
And like, I feel like that's the way to do it in 2019. Just be able to walk into a club or a venue and, you know, read the room and just be able to rock.
So I can't remember exactly which DJ said this, but I think it was between either Diplo or Zed. Correct me if I'm wrong. But they said something that EDM doesn't really have to go with this whole drop. Do you agree with that? Do you agree that that's what kind of makes EDM awesome? Do you agree that people have started let go of the whole drop?
I feel like for a couple years straight, that's all it was.
Right.
You know, and especially like if you're a rapid fire DJ, you're playing drop, 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 mm-hmm. drop. And like, I feel like that almost got beat up too much.
Yeah.
And so now we got to break it up a little bit and switch it up. So
yeah.
I totally agree with that.
I even got into it. We were just talking about this, the whole LimeWire days when you would get the 2012, 2013.
Oh
you good?
Yeah, I'm good. No, LimeWire, like, you know, that was amazing when that happened.
Amazing.
The gift and the curse, if you will.
I think
I killed a couple laptops with that. But.
R.I.P. to our old computer, 2007. But anyways, I got to tell you, who's someone that I always ask this, who's your dream collab? And I say this with a DJ, but also a vocalist.
A vocalist.
They're both kind of different entities to work with.
For me personally, I'm going to say Rita Ora. So Rita,
oh,
if you hear me,
okay.
I'm trying to holler. What's
yeah.
up?
Rita, you got this?
Right.
We've actually had our first hit sessions was with Rita.
Okay.
She was really dope.
No, she's a super dope person. Super talented.
Yeah. And what about DJ-wise?
DJ-wise, like I said, you know, Devolve and Camilo. Those are my big guys. I'm a big fan.
I love that. So what do we have coming up in 2019? What are we trying to accomplish? What are we putting out in the world?
We're trying to really ramp up mix shows radio-wise.
Okay.
You know, trying to touch much more markets and just step up the clubs and be in more cities. You know, I think that's the goal for anybody, though.
Right.
So.
I love that. So, DJ Heat, let us know. Where can we follow you on social media?
Hit me on that Instagram, DJ Heat Official, Twitter, DJ Heat, and I think that's good, baby.
There we go. It's Kelvin Live on the new Hits, 97.3 Hits Hotel.